very warm welcome to each one of you on the occasion of the 68th Independence Day of India. I'd like to particularly welcome all members of the Indian community, a community that is growing in numbers. Also, a very warm welcome to our Mexican friends and other friends of India. I want to congratulate the Indian community for its achievements and particularly single out Dr. Sanjay Rajaram, who has been awarded the World Food Prize for 2014. It's a matter of great pride and privilege for all of us to have him in our midst this morning. I now have the pleasure and the honor to read to you the President's address to the nation on the eve of Independence Day, 14 August 2014. Pyare Deshwasiyo, Hamari Swatantrata ki 67vi Varshgant ki Purva Sandhya par, मैं आपका और दुनिया भर में सभी भारतवासियों का हार्दिक अभिनंदन करता हूं। मैं हमारी सशस्त्र सेनाओं, अर्धसैनिक बलों तथा आंतरिक सुरक्षा बलों के सदस्यों को विशेष बधाई देता हूं। हाल ही में ग्लासगो में संपन्न राष्ट्रमंडल खेलों में भाग लेने वाले और सम्मान पाने वाले सभी खिलाड़ियों को भी बधाई देता हूं। Friends, freedom is a celebration. Independence is a challenge. In the 68th year of freedom, we have reaffirmed the power of our individual and collective liberties by electing, through a remarkably peaceful electoral process, a stable government with a clear majority for a single party. After 3 decades, the increase in voter turnout to 66% from the last elections, 58%, shows the vitality of our democracy. This achievement has given us an opportunity to take up the challenge of governance by reforming the policies, practices, and systems of governance so that the enormous aspirations of our people can be fulfilled with vision, commitment, integrity, speed, and administrative capability. Good governance is critically dependent on the rule of the law, participatory decision-making, transparency, responsiveness, accountability, equity, and inclusiveness. It calls for wider involvement of the civil society in the political process. It calls for deeper engagement of the youth with the institutions of democracy. It calls for quick dispensation of justice to the people. It calls for ethical and responsible behavior from the media. A country of our size, heterogeneity, and complexity calls for culture-specific governance models. It calls for cooperation in the exercise of power and assumption of responsibility by all stakeholders. It calls for constructive partnership between the state and the citizen. It calls for taking a responsive administration to the doorstep of every hut and habitation in the land. Fellow citizens, the decisive challenge of our times is to end the curse of poverty. The focus of our policies now has to move from alleviation of poverty to elimination of poverty. The difference is not mere semantics. Alleviation is a process. Elimination is a time-defined objective. In the last 6 decades, the poverty ratio has declined from over 60% to less than 30%. Even then, nearly one-third of our population still lives below the poverty line. Poverty is not a mere statistic. Poverty has a face which becomes unbearable when it scars the visage of a child. The poor cannot and will not wait for yet another generation to see the very essentials of life, food, shelter, education, and employment being denied to them. The benefits from economic development must percolate down to the poorest of the poor. In the last decade, our economy grew at an average rate of 7.6% per year. Though the growth rate was subdued at below 5% during the last 2 years, I sense renewed vigor and optimism in the air. Signs of revival are visible. Our external sector has strengthened. Fiscal consolidation measures are beginning to show results. Notwithstanding occasional spurts, inflation has started moderating. However, food prices still remain a matter of serious concern. Record food grains production last year helped the agriculture sector to grow at a healthy 4.7%. Employment has increased by an average of about 4% per year in the last decade. The manufacturing sector is on the rebound. The stage is now set for our economy to move on a high growth trajectory of 7 to 8%, which is essential to ensure the availability of adequate resources for equitable development. Fellow citizens, economy is the material part of development. Education is the essential part of it. A sound education system is the bedrock of an enlightened society. It is the bounden duty of our educational institutions to provide quality education and inculcate the core civilizational values of love for the motherland, compassion for all, tolerance for pluralism, respect for women, performance of duty, honesty in life, self-restraint in conduct, responsibility in action, and discipline in young minds. By the end of the 12th five-year plan, we would have achieved a literacy rate of 80%. But would we be able to say that we have provided quality education and skills to our children to be good citizens and successful professionals? My fellow citizens, though an ancient civilization, India is a modern nation with modern dreams. Intolerance and violence is a betrayal of the letter and spirit of democracy. Those who believe in the poison drip of inflammatory provocation do not understand India's values or even its present political impulses. Indians know that progress, economic or social, is difficult without peace. This may be the appropriate moment to recall the great Shivaji's letter to Aurangzeb, when the latter imposed jizya. Shivaji told the emperor that Shah Jahan, Jahangir, and Akbar could also have levied this tax, but they did not give place to bigotry in their hearts, as they considered all men, high and low, created by God to be examples of the nature of diverse creeds and temperaments. This 17th century epistle of Shivaji carries a message which is universal. It must become a living testament that guides our behavior today. We can least afford to forget this message at a time when an increasingly turbulent international environment has sparked off rising dangers in our region and beyond, some clearly visible and some crawling out of the debris of unprecedented turmoil. Across parts of Asia and Africa, attempts are being made by radical militias to redraw the maps of nations to create a geography for theocratic ideology. India will feel the heat of blowback, particularly as it represents the values that reject extremism in all its manifestations. India is a beacon of democracy, equilibrium, inter and intra-faith harmony. We must defend our secular fabric with vigor. Our security and foreign policies must combine the steel of strength with the velvet of diplomacy, even as we persuade the like-minded as well as the hesitant to recognize the substantial dangers that breed within indifference. अड़सठवीं वर्ष की आयु में एक देश बहुत युवा होता है। भारत के पास 21वीं सदी पर वर्चस्व कायम करने के लिए इच्छा शक्ति, ऊर्जा बुद्धिमत्ता मूल्य और एकता मौजूद है। गरीबी से मुक्ति की लड़ाई में विजय पाने का लक्ष्य तय किया जा चुका है। यह यात्रा केवल उनको ही विकट लगेगी जिनमें विश्वास का अभाव है। एक पुरानी कहावत है, सिद्धिर भवति कर्मजा, अर्थात सफलता कर्म से ही उत्पन्न होती है। अब समय आ गया है कि हम कार्य में जुट जाएं। जय हिंद।
जय हिंद।
थैंक यू वेरी मच।
Baila para hoy por nuestros días, los problemas, los que sean. ¡Salud! ¡Baila, baila! कविता जिसका शीर्षक है स्वतंत्र हिंदुवासियों पेश करती हूँ, आप सबकी इजाजत चाहती हूँ। स्वतंत्र हिंदुवासियों आजाद भारत की शान, स्वतंत्र हिंदुवासियों आजाद भारत की शान, फूलों फलों खूब तुम दुआ करता है हिंदुस्तान, फूलों फलों खूब तुम दुआ करता है हिंदुस्तान। चलो सिर ऊंचा करके, चलो सिर ऊंचा करके भारत देशवासियों, चलो सिर ऊंचा करके भारत देशवासियों, स्वतंत्रता पे कर लो नाज हिंदवासियों, स्वतंत्रता पे कर लो नाज हिंदवासियों। स्वतंत्रता दिवस है, स्वतंत्रता दिवस है, याद कर लो वीरों को, स्वतंत्रता दिवस है, याद कर लो वीरों को, आजाद हिंद फौज के सभी शहीदों को, आजाद हिंद फौज के सभी शहीदों को, स्वतंत्रता सेनानी को, स्वतंत्रता सेनानी को, बापू को पटेल को, स्वतंत्रता सेनानी को, बापू को पटेल को, भारत के फौजियों को सीमाओं पे खड़े जो, भारत के फौजियों को सीमाओं पे खड़े जो, हिफाजत में हम सबकी, हिफाजत में हम सबकी हो रहे हैं कुर्बान, हिफाजत में हम सबकी हो रहे हैं कुर्बान, ईमानदारी से है दे रहे वो लहू के हैं दान, ईमानदारी से है दे रहे वो लहू के हैं दान, माना कि दे सकते नहीं, माना कि दे सकते नहीं सभी वतन के लिए जान, माना कि दे सकते नहीं सभी वतन के लिए जान, पर सच्चाई और ईमानदारी से तो, पर सच्चाई और ईमानदारी से तो कर सकते हैं अपने काम, पर सच्चाई और ईमानदारी से तो कर सकते हैं अपने काम। भ्रष्टाचार का गंदा धब्बा ना लगे तिरंगे पे, भ्रष्टाचार का गंदा धब्बा ना लगे तिरंगे पे, बनता है फर्ज इतना तो हमारा देश के लिए, बनता है फर्ज इतना तो हमारा देश के लिए, आओ सत्यता ईमानदारी से, आओ सत्यता ईमानदारी से सब काम को करें, आओ सत्यता ईमानदारी से सब काम को करें, मिलजुल के वतन को ऊंचाइयों पे ले चले, मिलजुल के वतन को ऊंचाइयों पे ले चले, अनेकता में एकता की, अनेकता में एकता की प्रचंड शक्ति हम, अनेकता में एकता की प्रचंड शक्ति हम, माता को गर्व है हम पे अरबों की शक्ति हम, माता को गर्व है हम पे अरबों की शक्ति हम, कैसे है कोई एक, कैसे है कोई एक दुर्बल है रहने पाए, कैसे है कोई एक दुर्बल है रहने पाए, अरबों हैं हम देश में प्रबल उसको बनाए, अरबों हैं हम देश में प्रबल उसको बनाए, करें आओ कुछ ऐसा हम, करें आओ कुछ ऐसा हम जो हो स्वार्थ से परे, करें आओ कुछ ऐसा हम जो हो स्वार्थ से परे, कि फौजी भी कभी फक्र करे हमारे नाम पे, कि फौजी भी कभी फक्र करे हमारे काम पे। जय हिंद।
जय हिंद।
Sim pola pola sim sim pola sim sim pola pola sim sim pola pancha tripa patola chola chum 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 le sim pola sim pola hare rama 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 hare hare krishna 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 dum 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 dum
में छीने में ढूंढो तो मिल जाए कत्ता वो गीतों में दम है समाज निकले और कुल की आज निकले मन जाए ऐसी होली रग रग में चल के बोली दस है ना बस है नी जिद है तना जिद है जी किस नाएंगी किस नाएंगी किस नाएंगी पत करिए कोई तो चल जिद पढ़िए तुम पे तरिए या मरिए हम कोई तो
Oh, thank you.
Thank you very much.
For banana.
Thank you. Thank you very much.
Okay.
Okay, I'll put it.
Better them to put it.
Okay, thank you. Thank you.
Thank you. Thank you.
Refreshment. Kindly enjoy. It was a pleasure having you. Thank you very much.